Antibiotics can be defined as the substances produced or derived from living cells, mostly from the microorganisms, which are capable in small concentrations of inhibiting the life process or even destroying, that is killing the microorganisms. So these are substances produced or derived from living cells, mostly of the microorganisms, which is capable in small concentrations of inhibiting the life processes or even destroying the microorganisms. That is, antibiotics are low molecular weight microbial metabolites. Another definition can be, the antibiotics are low molecular weight microbial metabolites. That is, they are derived from the processes of the microorganisms that at low concentrations inhibit the growth of other organisms, other microorganisms. A simple definition for this: antibiotics are low molecular weight microbial metabolites that at low concentration inhibit the growth of other microorganisms. Antibiotics can be of two types: one which has a permanent effect and second which has a temporary effect. A permanent effect will be the ones which will kill the microorganisms, kill the other microorganisms. जो other microorganisms पे जिस पे ये act करते हैं उनको kill कर देते हैं, तो that will be coming under the permanent antibiotics. And this generally it was for bacteria, but nowadays it can act upon not only the bacteria but also protozoans and fungus. So it can be antifungal, antiprotozoal, or antibacterial. But generally, the definitions are for the antibacterial activities. क्योंकि ये पहले antibacterial activities के लिए ही लिए जाते हैं. So those which are having permanent effect, that is those which are capable of killing the microorganisms, killing the bacteria, protozoans, or fungus, those we call it as bactericidal. Those antibiotics are called as bactericidal antibiotics. They kill the microorganisms. The others are temporary effect. That is, their effect is lost when antibiotic is removed. जब तक हम एंटीबायोटिक लेते हैं तब तक उसका असर रहता है. एंटीबायोटिक लेना बंद कर दिया तो वहां पे उसका असर भी खत्म हो जाता है. सो दैट इज टेम्पररी इफेक्ट इज प्रेजेंट एंड सच वी कॉल इट एज अ बैक्टीरियोस्टैटिक. They do not kill the microorganisms, but they will just inhibit the growth of the microorganisms. So, such are called as bacteriostatic. So, there are two types of antibiotics. One is a bactericidal antibiotic. The other is a bacteriostatic antibiotics. The main characteristics of antibiotics are. Characteristic properties of antibiotics are that it must be a product of metabolism of a living organism. Antibiotic must be a product or metabolism of living organism. It should not be completely synthesized. It no, should not be a completely synthetic one. If at all it is a synthetic one, then it should be a analog, structural analog of it. Or it should be a structural analog of naturally occurring compound. Naturally occurring compound होना चाहिए या फिर naturally occurring compound का analog होना चाहिए, but it should not be a completely de novo synthetic one. 100% synthetic one नहीं चलता है, उसको हम antibiotic नहीं बोलते हैं, उसको हम drug बोलते हैं. Third property is that it should be effective in low concentrations. It should be effective in low concentrations, should not be required in higher concentrations. Then it should be stable for long enough period. एकदम से छोटा पीरियड भी नहीं होना चाहिए इसका, क्योंकि फिर हमें ज्यादा अमाउंट में देना पड़ेगा, and that is also not desirable. So it should have a shelf life for a longer period, sufficient period should be there before it loses the potency. And then fifth one is it should be able to antagonize one or more, or it should one or more pathogens. Antagonize means it should act upon one or more pathogens. Pathogens means bacteria and fungus वगैरह पे ये act होना चाहिए, या तो एक पर्टिकुलर बैक्टीरिया पे एक्ट होना चाहिए या फिर एक पर्टिकुलर क्लास ऑफ बैक्टीरिया पे एक्ट होना चाहिए. सो इट शुड बी स्पेसिफिक और इट शुड बी जनरल. देन द रेट ऑफ डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन, दैट इज रेट ऑफ रिमूवल ऑफ दिस एंटीबायोटिक, रेट ऑफ डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन और रेट ऑफ रिमूवल ऑफ दिस एंटीबायोटिक इन द बॉडी should be such that the dosage can be adjusted. क्योंकि ये detoxification इतना भी fast नहीं होना चाहिए क्योंकि हमें dose हम adjust ही नहीं कर सकते हैं. Means हमें हर एक एक घंटे में antibiotic लेने की जरूरत ना पड़े, या फिर ऐसा भी नहीं होना चाहिए कि एक दिन में एक ही बार लेना पड़े. It should be about 6 to 8 hours या 10 hours का उसका shelf detoxification period होना चाहिए, then it would be good one. The next characteristic property of antibiotic is that it should cause significant toxicity on pathogens, but not on humans. So these are the characteristic properties of antibiotics.
And we will see about the classification of antibiotics. Antibiotics can be classified depending on the functions, depending on their structure, and depending on their nature of activity against a certain reagents. We can classify them in different ways. First is, let us say we are classifying them based on activity, that is activity against the pathogens. Particularly the bacteria. It can be classified into two categories, two broad categories. First is a narrow spectrum antibiotics, and second is broad spectrum antibiotics. narrow spectrum antibiotics and broad spectrum antibiotics. Narrow spectrum are those which are highly specific and they act against a certain particular diseases only. They will be acting on a particular pathogens causing a particular disease only. So these are highly specific antibiotics. They cannot be used for all types of diseases, but they can be used only for a particular disease. Like the examples for this can be cephalosporin C. Bacitracin. Cephalosporin C is a broad spectrum. So this bacitracin, niacin, nystatin, erythromycin. These are examples for narrow spectrum antibiotics. ये एक particular disease के पे ही काम करते हैं, सभी diseases पर ये काम नहीं करते. दूसरा होता है कि broad spectrum antibiotics. Broad spectrum antibiotics में ये काफी सारे range पर ये काम करते हैं, काफी सारे range of diseases पर ये काम करते हैं. These are not so specific. Their specificity is low and they are active against the varied type of reagents. When against several ailments or infections, this broad spectrum can be used. So this can be non-specific antibiotics and they can be used up against several ailments or several diseases. Examples for this can be cephalosporin C, we also call it as a chloromycin, chloramphenicol, tetracyclines. These are examples for broad spectrum antibiotics which are effective in the treatment of a wide variety of microorganisms. So this was one type of classification of antibiotics based on its activity against a particular disease. Then we can classify antibiotics based on nature of activity, that based on type of bacteria they act upon. Based on type of bacteria that they act upon, they can be classified into three different categories. One as those which are active against gram-positive bacteria. Second, those which are active against gram-negative bacteria, and third, which are active against both positive and negative bacteria, gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. So this third category will be a broad spectrum category. First two will be a narrow spectrum category. Gram-positive bacteria, we can take an example of say penicillin, erythromycin. Although erythromycin is a broad spectrum link, but it is a narrow spectrum. Erythromycin is a narrow spectrum. Penicillin is also a narrow spectrum. It is acting upon the gram-positive bacteria. Second, that is gram-negative bacteria. Examples can be typhoid bacillus bacteria, which are gram-negative bacteria. Example for a gram-positive bacteria are leprosy bacillus, which causes leprosy. for this gram-negative bacteria, we can have typhoid, bacillus as an example for bacteria. Examples for antibiotics can be streptomycin, neomycin can be examples for gram-negative bacteria. That is antibiotics which are acting upon gram-negative bacteria. Those antibiotics which are active against both the positive and negative bacteria are cephalosporin C, chloramphenicol, ampicillin, tetracyclines, etc. These are all the broad spectrum antibiotics are all active against both the gram positive and gram negative bacteria. इसमें हम ग्राम पॉजिटिव एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव हम कैसे करते हैं कि दिस वाज क्लासिफाइड और दिस क्लासिफिकेशन वाज गिवन बाय क्रिश्चियन ग्राम एंड दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नेम्ड एज ग्राम पॉजिटिव एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया. ये मेथड हमको दिया था क्रिश्चियन ग्राम ने एंड इट इज कॉल्ड एज ग्राम स्टेनिंग, gram staining method. This is called as a gram staining method. इसमें हम क्या करते हैं कि bacterial smear लेते हैं what is smear? Smear is a tissue or a part of a bacteria. जिसको हम लेते हैं a part of a bacteria or a part of a tissue is called as a smear. If it is bacteria का होता है तो बैक्टीरियल स्मियर, ह्यूमन बींग्स का होता है तो ह्यूमन स्मियर. तो ये स्मियर को हम लेते हैं एंड दैट इज ट्रीटेड विद क्रिस्टल वायलेट. इट इज ट्रीटेड विद फर्स्ट क्रिस्टल वायलेट डाई एंड आयोडीन जिससे कि ये ब्लू कलर में हो जाता है. इसको ब्लू कलर लग जाएगा एंड देन दिस इज वॉश्ड यूजिंग अल्कोहल सो दैट alcohol acts as a decolorizing agent and then this is treated with safranin. Safranin is a red dye. So first it is treated with crystal violet dye and iodine so that it acquires blue color or violet in color and then it is treated with decolorizing material alcohol and finally with the safranin which is a red dye. The gram-positive bacteria retain this violet color. Gram-positive bacteria will have violet color after treatment with safranin also. And gram-negative bacteria will have acquired red color after treatment with safranin. जो gram-positive bacteria होते हैं उनका ये violet color नहीं जाता है upon decolorization and safranin dye के साथ ट्रीट करने के बाद भी उसका वायलेट कलर रहता है और ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया में ये वायलेट कलर चला जाता है और सैफ्रिनिन का रेड कलर आ जाता है. सो दैट इज हाउ वी क्लासिफाई देम इनटू ग्राम पॉजिटिव एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया. सो दिस वाज वन टाइप ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ बैक्टीरिया टू ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट एंटीबायोटिक्स कैन बी क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री कैटेगरीज. Those acting against gram-positive bacteria, those acting against gram-negative bacteria, and those acting against both the gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. Third category of classification is based on chemical structure. This is what we are more interested in. Based on chemical structure, how this antibiotics can be classified. They can be classified into various different categories. First is beta lactams. We have beta lactams in penicillins and cephalosporins. These are all the examples of beta lactams. Beta lactam mein kya hota hai? It is having a carboxyl group. To that carboxyl group, this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. Beta carbon possessing nitrogen. अमीन ग्रुप, सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए बीटा कार्बन पोजिशन अमीन ग्रुप. लेकिन यहाँ पे लैक्टम है, लैक्टम ये आर ऑल साइक्लिक अमाइड्स, साइक्लिक अमाइड्स आर कॉल्ड एज लैक्टम्स. अगर साइक्लिक एस्टर है तो वी कॉल इट एज लैक्टोन्स, अगर अमाइड है तो लैक्टम्स होते हैं. और उसमें लैक्टम में जो अमाइड में जो नाइट्रोजन जो होता है, वो नाइट्रोजन अगर बीटा कार्बन पे प्रेजेंट है देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए बीटा लैक्टम. दिस रिंग वी कॉल इट एज ए बीटा लैक्टम. So this is four membered cyclic amide, it's called as a beta lactam. If it is a five membered cyclic amide, this is four membered five membered cyclic amide agar hoga hamare paas, then we call this as a this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon, this is gamma carbon, so it is a gamma lactam. This is our beta lactam. So depends on at what carbon this nitrogen is present of the amide, we can classify them into beta, gamma, delta lactams. But antibiotics may generally ye beta lactams hote hain. So those antibiotics which possesses this beta lactam rings are classified under beta lactams. Then there are tetracyclines. Tetracyclines have four. Used six membered rings, four fused six membered rings are present in tetracyclines. They may be aromatic, they may not be aromatic. Examples for this can be teramycin, aromycin, can be examples of tetracyclines. Then third category is amino glycosides. They have amine group as well as sugar is attached to it. So glycosidically sugar is attached to an amine group. So those we call it as a amino glycosides. So, they have a attached to via glycosidic bond. Examples for this can be streptomycin, neomycin, then we have microliths. Microliths are arch lactones. Lactones are cyclic esters. So large or large ring sized lactones called or classified under this microliths. Examples for this can be erythromycin, donomycin, donomycin can also be classified under tetracyclines. It has four six membered rings, and also it can be classified under aminoglycosides because वहाँ पे sugar है, sugar molecule amine group को attached होता है. So donomycin is a one which can be classified in macrolides, it can be classified in aminoglycosides and also in the tetracyclines. We can have polypeptides. Antibiotics which has polypeptide chains in the antibiotic acting as an antibiotic. Examples can be bacitracin or trithyretin. Examples of polypeptides acting as the antibiotics. Then we can have polyenes, that is those which are having multiple double bonds, complicated double bonds are present. Example, nystatin or amphotericin. Then we have phenyl propane diol derivatives. Phenyl propane diol derivatives. Uh, which contains phenylpropanediol amines as a skeleton. And examples for this can be chloromycetin, and its derivatives. Propanediol, that is also called as a chloromycetin, which have phenylpropanediol derivatives present in it. We have sulfonamides, this includes benzene sulfonamide derivatives, and examples for this can be antimetabolites. Then we have last category, that is phenolic oxalic acids. Phenolone carboxylic acids possesses phenolone 3 carboxylic acid derivative, and they show antibacterial activities. Examples can be highly specific antibacterial antibiotics. We are example is a fluoroquinolone 3 carboxylic acid. We are highly specific antibiotics. So this was about the classification of antibiotics into 3 different groups. First was depending on whether they act upon gram-positive, gram-negative bacteria, and second, whether they are specific or non-specific as a narrow spectrum and broad spectrum.